chorus and our band tonight, we are definitely celebrating the Beatles. This year in music class for 5th and 6th grade, we spent about 6 weeks kind of diving into the history of the Beatles, very vaguely, not as in-depth as I would like to go, kind of like in honor of the fact that Sir Paul McCartney was just here in Syracuse, Ringo Starr was also in Canada as well, like 5 days before that, and which is kind of a cool chance for the kids to get to know about music history and their impact on popular music as we know it. So instead of me introducing all of the songs, I'm actually going to have the kids do it. And one of my most favorite things this year was to give, every time we would do a song, I would give the kids kind of some fun trivia facts about each of the songs, like how the song got the name, or what inspired either Paul McCartney or John Lennon to write the song, or in the case of Octopus and Star and the Ringo Star. So please enjoy the fun facts I'm going to share with you. And our first two presenters tonight are Carly and Kennedy.
Sergeant Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band. This song received its name from the salt and pepper packets. Paul was traveling home from vacation with his tour manager. He and his tour manager would often banter about their two songs.
Paul was trying to think of a fictional name as he liked to do for most of his songs, and as they were eating, they noticed the salt and pepper packets. So Paul started saying, "Salt and Pepper, Sergeant Pepper," and the name was born. This song was never released on an album, but has a double single with the song Danger Tripper.
This song was written after Paul had a disagreement with his girlfriend Jane Asher. The first 8 measures were written by Paul, but the next 8 measures were written by John. John's section was written at the impatient time, basically telling his friend to go away.
right, so it would be remiss of me to not take a moment and acknowledge all of our sixth grade students. We have a ton of them in our course this year, and it has been an amazing year with the sixth graders. It's been a joy, first of all, to be back in person with students again. I've missed them horribly. It's so nice to be able to get back and create music with them, and I think that they have surprised themselves a lot with what they're able to do. Musically speaking, it's been just a great year. So I'm going to take a moment, I'm going to go through and I'm going to read out all of our sixth grade participants' names. They're going to do a quick wave just so you can see them. And then if you could please hold your applause until after I'm done acknowledging all of them, that would probably take less time for me. So our first sixth grade student that I'm going to mention is Noah Keller, Allison Goss, Jackson Allen, Dylan Champion, Santiago Navarro, Santiago, I massacred your name, that's embarrassing. Isabel Farley, Abigail Farley, Kaylee Wass, Sharma Southworth, Taylor Pisano, Max Lewin, Kennedy Hart, Savannah Searfrost DeGrasse, Riley Treed, Holly Schneider, Sophia Taylor, Roman Liverman, Isabella Rothrock, Seth Miner, Lucas Walters, Emily Delaney, Celia Clark, Cadence Reed, Jocelyn Vasquez. Nick Goss, Connor Scanlon, Uriah Gonzalez, Finley Tarb, Natalia Webb, Michaela Jones, Amelia Bean, Don Mull, Sam Sandoval, Kaden Brand, Tristan Sacco, Salem Welsky, Delilah Vasquez. And those are our sixth grade students. And Jake, oh my goodness. So I went through my senior chart list and I real quick before, so of course I made some mistakes. So let's not forget about Brooke Clovesy and Jade Durake. Okay, so I didn't say their names very often. We think after 7 years, right now, I left one out, but I gotta tell you that this young man is going to be so missed for me, because I think since the day he walked into Granby School, he has been my right hand guy. And if it weren't for him, I probably would never be able to find anything in my room, nor would anything technological ever work. So, Carter Bell.
Thank you. Oh.
So the title, A Hard Day's Night, which is actually playing, was inspired by Ringoism, which Ringo Starr was the Beatles drummer, would often say funny expressions or phrases during recording sessions. And once during a recording session, he had said that he had put in a hard day's night, which means he had worked all day, all night, reflecting the title, Hard Day's Night.
Take him to his destination, Paul began making chit-chat and asked the chauffeur how his day was. And the chauffeur answered that he was so busy it felt like he was working 8 days a week. Paul immediately thought that phrase would make a possible song title.
Before we play our last song, which is our full group song tonight, I want to recognize our sixth grade friends who are participating in band. And once again, awesome group of kids have worked really hard. Six of these sixth grade friends' names that I'm going to read were actually the ones that survived virtual online lessons last year with me, which we've all agreed is a big bummer. We hope we never have to go back to do that again. But they have all done really, really well. So I'm going to call their names, and I'm going to ask them to stand. And after all the names are read, then we'll give them a big round of applause, and they can do their bow to acknowledge their applause. So here we go. Isabel Farley, Abigail Kinney, Carter Bell, Taylor, Jocelyn Vasquez, Ian Clark, Haley Was, Riley Salamone, Natalia Webb, Jackson Allen, Allison Goss, Achille Capoletti, Lucas Walters, Peyton Brand, Dylan Champion, Riley Trude, Connor Scanlon, Caleb Coffey, Max Loomis, and Keegan Bertrand. Basically, the whole back row right now are sixth graders. And let's see what happens. Amelia Bean, stand up. All right, put her on the
Thank you. folk song.
Thank you.
She is playing with us back on the piano, so let's give her a big round of applause. Together, which is amazing. But it will be really hard to say goodbye to these